Hello, Capricorns. It is the Sun Sage. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to another love reading. So, Capricorn placements, I do want to take a look at your love life to see what's going on for you, Sun, Moon, Venus, and Rising Capricorns, and any other Capricorn placements in your chart that may resonate for you. This can also resonate for cross watchers, okay? So, let's see, Capricorns, what's going on in your love life. Let's take a look. King of Pentacles. Meeting your equal. I feel like a lot of you feel like you're too good for a lot of people. I think this King of Pentacles comes through as you. I think this King of Pentacles comes through as a lot of you feeling like you're too good for a lot of people. The Wheel of Fortune. Something is about to change your mind or change your heart. Five of Cups. So look, there's judgment. What I'm picking up, Capricorns, is that there's something about the way that you are looking at relationships that could actually be hurting your love life. Okay. That feeling of no one is good enough for me, that feeling of I'm okay alone, that feeling of nobody can top what I can do for me is essential to, you know, you protecting boundaries and you knowing your worth and your value. But there's something about it, Five of Cups, that's hurting your love life. All right. And judgment is you're getting another reminder of that right now. Let's keep going. The Hierophant. There's Capricorns here that need to be a little more flexible in love. There's something about the way you've always done things. What is it getting you? Page of Swords. Okay. So, look, there's Capricorns that are kind of like going back to square one. That means starting dating sites or, going back out on dates. And there's something about relationships and stabilities right here with you that they're not lasting. You give off relationship vibes. You are a committed, dedicated person. But I feel like there's energies that as you go into like a new beginning of your life and you're starting over again with the Ace of Wands, don't forget a very important lesson. Okay. Let me see what was going on with this King of Pentacles. This could absolutely be someone else. Okay. But it definitely feels like you. It feels like your high standards. It feels like you. Two of Wands. Seven of Wands. Having difficulties. Making important decisions when it comes to your love life. All right. You guys could feel like there's somebody making, having difficulties making an important decision when it comes to you. And I do feel that, but I feel strongly that you guys are struggling to create stability in romantic relationships. The Knight of Pentacles. Someone is moving too slow. Five of Wands. Yeah, it's just difficult. The Lovers, you could even have somebody here that's being patient or you're being patient with someone. There's a strong chemistry here between you and a person. Lovers, you have a Gemini for some of you. Also Taurus, very strongly. I'm getting very strong Taurus and Gemini here. There's somebody who's been waiting for you. Yeah, there's someone here waiting for you. And I get that in you guys' reading a lot. And you still may be feeling like they're not good enough for you. The Knight of Pentacles with the Five of Wands. You're moving slow because you're not trusting or they're not coming through as what you want or need right now or something. Or they're moving slow because they're indecisive. What's the Five of Wands? The Queen of Cups. Whenever you start having feelings for someone, because I got this Seven of Wands here at the bottom again, I feel like whenever you start caring about someone, loving someone, having feelings for them, it creates an inner conflict with you where you start to question it because it doesn't feel practical love to you. And so again, something has to change. The Wheel of Fortune. I feel like you are soft. Like this feels like giving yourself permission to be soft and to be vulnerable here, because the Wheel of Fortune is saying you're getting a chance or another chance to let someone love you and you're still resisting. Seven of Wands. What's the Wheel of Fortune? There's a person here who's trying to break through. The Tower, the breakthrough. Yeah. Somebody here has been very strong dealing with you. Could be a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Strength. They're very strong. Could be a Leo. Look, whoever it is, this person sees a life with you, the Star. They believe in this relationship with you. This person wishes for you more than they wish for anything else, the Star. But you feel very resistant, okay? I feel like this is definitely a sign that past connections have made you hesitant to trust, to give your all to anyone. But again, you're getting an opportunity. Okay. Ace of Cups. Either somebody's coming back around, you're about to reach out to somebody, or you're about to meet somebody new. And you have to be careful of that whole kind of like hard to get, Four of Cups, you know, you don't want anybody type energy, because I feel like you do. It's just difficult for some of you to admit, and it's difficult for some of you to trust here. What's the Ace of Cups? The Seven of Pentacles, somebody who is absolutely serious about investing, especially if they're a water sign. Knight of Cups here, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. I do feel like someone's about to make you a love offer. And I kind of feel like with this Ace of Cups, Seven of Cups, they've been trying to make you a love offer for a while. This person hasn't given up, but you have been rejecting them, Five of Cups, or something hasn't been working. Something just hasn't been working. The Page of Cups. You keep getting friend zoned, situationshipped type energy. What's the Page of Cups here? It's the Knight of Swords. I feel like there's someone here. All of these energies kind of have their head down. I feel like there's a love offer coming in and you're about to miss it again. I feel like you're about to miss it again because... What's the Knight of Swords? You could be being mean to someone right now, isolating yourself, the Knight of Swords with the Hermit. You're upset with someone, I feel. And you miss this person. This person misses you. But you feel like it's best to not talk to them. Death and the Three of Cups. And there have been plenty of opportunities to reconnect that haven't gone through. There's another important opportunity to reconnect with what could be a King of Cups. Somebody who still has feelings for you or loves you, who hasn't given up on you. But this person wants to know, are you ready? Okay, are you ready for a relationship? And I kind of still feel like you're still going to give them the runaround. What's the Hierophant? It's the World. Some of you aren't ready. There could be somebody here that's not ready for you. But some of you are the ones that are not ready for a long-term relationship to shit. You feel like you have a lot of worldly things you want to accomplish. You want to travel more. You want to make more money. Ten of Wands. And you're definitely taking on a lot. And then there's the Seven of Wands again. You're the one that's resisting. You actually have a person here who wants you and who wants to be with you. And I feel like you guys have made it incredibly difficult for this person to enter your world. And so they, at some point, I feel like they stopped trying to enter your world. At some point, I think this person felt like you were too much to deal with, and they were just going to take a lot of the load off of themselves. All right. Somebody decided to cut you off, Queen of Swords. Some of you could absolutely have made that decision to cut someone off because they were taking too long. They just weren't ready. They weren't sure. Again, strongly feeling your energy, but the Fool here is coming through like you're getting another chance to try something different. And I do feel like there's somebody here who's serious about you, but this person is not going to let you stress them out. What's this Queen of Swords? It's the Three of Pentacles. They're willing to work with you, Capricorn. They're willing to, like, you know, what do you need? You need more patience. You need more time. What is it? They're very serious about you. The Devil, very serious about you. You drive this person crazy, by the way. Okay, Queen of Swords, Three of Pentacles, the Devil. This person is, like, so patient with you. I feel like they try to understand you in that Queen of Swords energy. I feel like this person tries to keep the lines of communication open. I feel like this is someone who knows that you may be stuck on your old ways and you just may just have a very tough time believing to see the good in people. But there's a fresh start being offered very soon. What's the Devil? Someone is hooked on you. Six of Swords. But I do feel it's kind of like they're like, are you going to, like, have mercy on me now, Capricorns? Are you going to take it easy on this person? Is ready for you to take it easy on them. All right. Page of Swords. I don't see where they're going anywhere, but they're definitely not going to subject themselves, I feel, to, like, feeling unwanted by you. The Emperor. That whole energy of someone not being good for you, good enough for you, I'm sorry. The Page of Swords, Emperor, and the Moon. This person is showing up in some way, going, I have flaws. This, you intimidate me a little bit, right? But I am good enough for you. What's the Moon? Pisces again, Aries energy, the King of Wands. Yeah, King of Wands, they're confident. They feel like they are good enough for you. There's justice. They feel like you guys would be great together. You've given someone a very difficult time. And this isn't always a bad thing, because it's like how you see somebody's willing to fight for you. I do feel like you guys have definitely pushed someone to their fullest potential in order to be with you. But I also feel where this is someone who gives off an energy of, don't let me go, right? Because if that happens, I already see where you guys are kind of sad that y'all don't talk or you're missing them. You know, they're kind of just like making it clear, look, I'll be sticking around, but I may not for much longer. Leo energy here, Aries. Somebody's like, don't push it, basically, right? They still want to be with you. They're willing to work through anything, heal with you. Aquarius energy with the Star. This person really believes, has a lot of faith in a relationship with you. But I think they're going to be very clear with you, very honest with you. I'm a catch too. And, you know, again, I want you, but I don't have to wait around for this. Four of Swords, but I feel like they are going to wait around for you. I get that in you guys' reading a lot. Somebody really does know and appreciate your value, though, Capricorn. I think you're going to start talking more to this person, Eight of Wands. I think you are going to, like, try to let this person in. I feel like this is someone you can feel safe with. I feel like, you know, when you need space, they back up. When you want interaction, they take action towards you. This is somebody who feels like they'll go at whatever pace you need them to go at. What's the Three of Cups? Is there a reunion coming in? Judgment. Yeah, there's a reunion with somebody from, I feel, who you've kind of been in this, like, thing with. And what's Judgment? Scorpio here. This is Seven of Cups. You guys have to, like, establish intentions again, because you guys are in a space where you spent a lot of time apart or you haven't talked in a while. And so you don't know what the other wants. There's, you know, are you single? Yeah, I'm single. Are you single? It's kind of that you have to get, like, to know each other again, because you have been on a break. But while you guys were on this break, this person was healing themselves. they were healing themselves, and I feel like preparing themselves to come back to you. I think you hurt this person's pride a little bit. Four of Swords, Two of Pentacles. Yeah, they're coming back. I definitely feel where they're gonna, you know, choose to like throw their hat in the ring with you again. This is someone who really does value you and really does see your worth and wants to be with you. Something about you coming into their life this time, or them coming back into your life this time with the Five of Swords, they're not gonna let you get away with anything, right? I feel like this person is going to be standing up for themselves. They're going to be like, you know, very like, firm with you, you know, in this Five of Swords energy. You could feel like this, you and this person are clashing, but they're really just trying to like, I feel like they're fighting for your love. Okay. I really feel that heavy in this energy. This person is fighting for your love. All right. Okay, Capricorn, that is what I have for you. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe if this resonated for you. And if you're interested in a personal reading with me, check out the details in the description box.